हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम अगेन ऑन माय यूट्यूब चैनल माइक्रोबायोलॉजी बाय संतोष नपते। ऑलरेडी वी हैव स्टार्टेड दैट फर्स्ट यूनिट दैट इज बैक्टीरियल कल्टीवेशन एंड मेंटेनेंस। एंड इन यस्टरडे लेक्चर वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द डिफरेंट मेथड्स और डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ कल्चर मीडिया दैट वॉज अकॉर्डिंग टू द functional use or applications. In today's lecture we will see about the pure culture techniques or culture methods. So if you want to grow these microorganisms or bacteria in laboratory, at that time, as we have seen earlier or in last lecture, that there is a requirement of special type of nutrient media or culture media. So in addition to that culture media, you will require a special technique with the help of which you can grow or you can cultivate these bacteria in laboratory. So in today's lecture we will see about these different culture methods, or we can say here different pure culture techniques. So the first one is strict culture method or strict plate method, then lawn culture, stroke culture, then step culture, then pore plate method, and one more method is here that is called as spread plate technique or spread plate method. So these are the different techniques which are useful for the culturing of microorganisms or bacteria in laboratory. So these strict culture technique or strict plate method, then pore plate method, and that sixth one, that is spread plate method, these are the most common techniques for the isolation or culturing of bacteria. In addition to that, in some special instances there is a use of these lawn culture, stroke culture or step culture. So one by one we will see here, starting from the strict culture technique, or that is also called as strict plate method. So this special technique or strict culture technique, it is useful or used for the isolation of bacteria in pure form or in pure culture from a clinical specimens. And here there is a use of one wire loop that is called as Necrom wire loop, or it is the platinum wire loop, but more specifically or commonly there is a use of Necrom wire loop. So one loop full of the specimen, it is transferred onto the surface of a well dried plate which consists of the nutrient medium, and then spread over a small area at the periphery. Then this inoculum is then distributed thinly over the plate by streaking it with the help of that Necrom wire loop in a series of parallel lines in different segments of the plate. And after incubation there is a occurrence of separated colonies on the or over the last series of streaks. See, this is the diagram here. This is the petri plate or a petri dish, and in which that nutrient medium is added. So after addition of that inoculum, or after taking of that inoculum with the help of that Necrom wire loop, there is a streaking is carried out in this way. See, this is the first streaking here. See, apply loop full of culture, that is the starting of streaking here. So in this direction here, clockwise direction we can see here. Then later on, without taking again that culture or that inoculum, just you have to streak again with the help of that wire loop here. See again this in this way. So in this way there is a streaking is done with the help of that Necrom wire loop. And after 24 hours of incubation at 37 degrees Celsius, and in that incubator there will, such colonies will be appear here. So whatever these colonies, this one or this one, these are the colonies of the bacterial culture. So now these colonies are in pure form here. So we can subculture on the fresh nutrient medium or on the fresh culture medium or in the fresh culture medium plate. So this is the strict plate method. Second one is here, that is called as lawn culture. So such type of method or this lawn culture, it provides a uniform surface growth of the bacterium. And these lawn cultures, these are prepared by flooding the surface of that nutrient or petri plate with a liquid suspension of the desired bacterium or culture. So such type of lawn cultures, these are useful for the typing of bacteriophages. These are also useful for checking of antibiotic sensitivity or for antibiotic sensitivity testing, and these are useful in the preparation of bacterial antigens as well as vaccines. So these are the uses of lawn culture. See, this is the diagram which shows the result of antibiotic sensitivity testing. See, whatever this white disc you are observing here, these are of the antibiotics, different antibiotics, and surrounding to that there is a zone is there. So this zone, it is due to the inhibitory action of that antibiotic, and this zone is called as zone of inhibition. So this antibiotic sensitivity testing, it can be done with the help of lawn culture. Then next method is there, that is called as stroke culture technique. So this stroke culture, it is made in the test tubes which consist of agar slopes or which consist of agar slant. See, this is the slant test tube or agar slant here. So here there is a maximum nutrient medium is there, but after addition of that nutrient medium in the test tube, then that test tube is kept in a slanted position, and after solidification, so that media will distributed in these test tubes in this manner. Then this test tube, it is called as slant. So, and later on with the help of Nichrom wire loop, that specific culture is strict on this agar slant here. So this is called as the stroke culture, and the uses of this stroke culture techniques, that is, it provides a pure growth of a bacterium for slide agglutination as well as for other diagnostic techniques or test. The next one is here, that is called as stap culture techniques. So these are prepared by puncturing a suitable medium, for example gelatin or glucose agar, with a long straight charged Nichrom wire loop. Uses demonstration of gelatin liquefaction, then demonstration of oxygen requirements of the bacterium under study, and these are also useful for the maintenance of stock cultures in the laboratory. So this is the technique here, that is stap culturing. So in this way, this is the Nichrom wire loop here, and this is the agar slant. So there is a direct puncturing of this culture with the help of this wire loop into this nutrient medium here or here. So after incubation, so that growth will be like this here. So this is the stap culture. Next very important method is here, that is pore plate technique, or that is called as pore plate culture. So in this technique, 1 ml of the inoculum is added to the molten agar. Then it is mixed well, and later on it is poured to a sterile petri plate or petri dish. Then it is allowed to set or to become solidify. Then later on, after solidification, that plate is kept in the incubator for 24 hours of incubation at 37 degrees Celsius. And after that, there will be, after completion of incubation period, there will be growth of that bacterium will be takes place here. So uses, it gives an estimate of the viable bacterial count in a suspension, and these are also useful for the quantitative culturing of urines. So this is the diagram of pore plate method here. See, this is the bacterial inoculation or dilution we can see here. Then 1 or 0.1 ml culture is added in this test tube, that is plate here. Then inoculate that empty plate. This is the first step in the pore plate method, and that 0.1 ml or 1 ml sample or suspension is added. Then after that, that molten nutrient agar is added in that nutrient agar plate, or in that plate in which that suspension is added. Or we can add this suspension directly into this medium, and then we can pour that medium into the sterile petri plate. Okay, then these plates are rotated to mix that culture as well as nutrient medium, and then these plates are incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for at least 24 hours. And after incubation, there will be separated colonies will be appear in that petriplet or in that nutrient agar plate or any other medium. So this is the pore plate method. And the next method is here, that is called as spread plate method. So what is done in that spread plate method? So whatever that sterile nutrient agar plate is here, which is consisting of sterile nutrient media, and on that nutrient media that 0.1 ml or less suspension is added or poured with the help of sterile pipette, and later on with the help of that sterile glass spreader there is a spreading of that suspension throughout that medium, and then that plates are incubated at 37 degrees Celsius for at least 24 hours of incubation, and after that incubation period that colonies will be appear here. So this is about the spread plate technique, that is surface colonies here. See this diagram also here, 0.1 ml sample is added on that petri plate containing nutrient media, then it is spreaded with the help of that glass spreader, and that plates are incubated at specific temperature or optimum temperature for at least 24 hours, and after incubation that plates now they consist of the different colonies in this way. So this is called as the spread plate method. So this is the diagram of spread plate method, and this is the diagram of pore plate method, which we have already explained. So this is about the different techniques of our pure culture techniques or culture techniques. So here we have completed about that three lectures about the bacterial cultivation and maintenance. Remaining portion of this unit you will see tomorrow. So kindly subscribe this Microbiology by Santosh Napte, share these videos and comment on it. Thank you.